I couldn't make that jump. You played it once as a kid? Yeah, it's hard as a kid to understand the concept of the game, but I got it. It was like the first or second game. I think the first game I got was... Yeah, well, because the Sega Genesis came with Sonic 1. And then this was the game I got next. So I had this game since it's come out. Sonic Spinball. Sonic Spinball was one of those games that, like, I played a bunch, but I never beat as a kid. 20 hours in the past 30. All right, Smajir, take care, man. Thank you for coming back, hanging out, kicking it. I'm sure I will see you next time. I'll be streaming Bloodborne, which will be my first playthrough, but it's not like a blind playthrough. It's blind in the fact that I don't particularly know where I'm going, but I've seen millions of speedruns, not millions, but I've seen hundreds of speedruns. I've seen man versus game play this game up and down. I've read the 50-page document on the lore, so when I play Bloodborne, we can definitely talk lore for sure. It's not a let's not spoil Jeg thing. I still owe you Gungeon YouTube. I need time for Gungeon YouTube, but yes, I do. I do owe you. Happy that life's turning my way for once. Me too. But I do owe you some Gungeon. I haven't touched any game like Isaac or Gungeon in a while. You never beat Spinball either. You got to the last level and got mad. Oh, you game over from a time limit? Oh, man. I probably wouldn't pick it up anymore after that. That game's tough, surprisingly. My favorite Sonic game is still Sonic CD, followed by Sonic 2, followed by Sonic 1, and then the rest I don't necessarily care about at all. Sonic 4 is pretty good. My favorite stage of all Sonic games is Spring Yard Zone. I think it has an amazing, cool look, and the music is my favorite music in any Sonic game. And Family Jewels' remix of it, it's amazing. It's just, it's good. It's goodness in music form. Sonic Jam was weird. Yeah, I know, it's gonna be tough, Valued. Having to go dex instead of strength, like, getting used to just dodging everything all the time instead of having a shield, it's gonna be weird. Definitely. I still haven't gotten a ship piece yet, and this is stage 4. But I am making good pace on the stages-ish. And then they had that Sonic fighting game, which was also kind of weird. Can't wait for Sonic Mania. The first classic looking Sonic game you've looked forward to in a while. I've not heard of Sonic Mania. Are they finally going back to the old formula? Because wasn't Sonic 4 supposed to go back to the old formula? But they'd never finished past episode 2 or something like that. I know they finished episode 1, but then they just kind of stopped there or something. Wait, was there a So there's a rocket ship piece here. Show me where it's at. Oh, it's way over there. Okay. That's fine, though. This is still salvageable because the time is good. We don't have many ship pieces, but we're making great time through the stages. So it's worth going still. Just got announced last month. It's about time they went back to that. I think they finally just kind of really learned and realized that's all people want with Sonic games. They just want that old school style. Don't change it. Just make the game and give the people what they want, man. We don't need any of this action adventure stuff. We don't need no Sonic and the Excalibur sword and all this weirdness, werewolf stuff, werehog, whatever you want to call it. Like, we don't need none of that. Just give us a dude who goes fast and runs on the side of the screen so we can see some people speedrun it. I'm pretty sure Worcester's looking forward to that. Hopefully. Well, I'm not pretty sure. I would assume he would try it. There's no ship piece here, which is good because this stage sucks very much. And I just want to hurry up and get off it because I don't have any unfalls. Along with Sonic 2017. Oh, so they're coming out with two Sonic games. So one's going to be the old style and one's going to be like whatever they want so they can see which one does better. Maybe. All the old Sonic games, but like in a Chaos Realm. So Sonic 1 levels are merged literally into Sonic CD levels. That sounds interesting. Huh. That sounds awesome though. Like, I'd play that for sure. The games I'm looking forward to the most is, of course, this remake of Toe Jam and Earl when it finally comes out. I'm definitely going to speedrun that. If it is what they say it is. Which is supposed to be this, basically this, but with new graphics. So if it's this with just new graphics, then yes, I will be speedrunning it. Alright, where's their phone? Oh, there's the elevator. Ship piece? There's a ship piece. Alright, where's the phone? Yeah, there's a new one of these. I was a backer for it. It's gonna be on Steam. I don't remember all the consoles. But if you look up, if you Google Toe Jam and Earl Back in the Groove, you'll see. Well, I don't know if they're necessarily calling it a remake or a reboot or what, but it's basically supposed to be in this style because Panic on Funkatron and the third game on Xbox were not this style and they didn't do well. So, yeah. They're going to fix that mistake. Get away from me. I don't like these guys. I hope the music's as good too. Alright. Like, he moves too fast. He outspeeds me too much. Go away. What are you doing? Jeez Louise. I should have used it at first so I didn't die, but I thought if I died I could just get past him, but I forgot there was boogeymen here. But yeah, this Bloodstained, I will have a full answer after I play the demo. That's on Steam. Persona 5, even though I still don't know anything about it, and I'm going to keep it that way. I want to play that game as 100% blind as possible. I'm Toe Jam. Oh good, we got another ship piece here. Let's find it and we can be back on pace. And then the Dark Souls 3 DLC, of course. I think there was one more game. Well, I guess now this Sonic game, Sonic Mania. Two tornadoes. Go away, you scrubs. All right, Valier, take care, man. Thank you for kicking it. Wow, this stage is huge for level 8. What the heck, man? Go away. I'm gonna have to use high tops or he's gonna kill me. Wow, that's the most useless telephone I've ever seen. I've also never seen them in a straight vertical line before. Carrot man, do I have anything for you? I have $9, but no presents. Tekken 7 PC. Oh, Tekken 7 should be good. So I can play with Akuma. Come on, where's my ship piece? Come on! We're not gonna be that far behind. Just give it to me. Please? Ah, there it is. Alright, so what I'm gonna do... Split. They removed Bruce. It's because he's so OP. I'm gonna identify these presents first. Alright. I'm gonna save the wings. They're that green present though. That's good to know. I'll save them for now. Our time is okay-ish. We're still ahead on splits. And we're still under the 2 minute per stage kind of time frame mindset. That's kind of the mindset you want to be in, is like 2 minutes per stage. And we're under that. I won't buy anything. There's a copy-paste version of him now? Really? Oh, they nerfed her. That's dumb. I almost got picked up by that tornado. I wasn't paying attention. The nerds. A girl from Brazil. Did they drop her after they saw Laura? Lawnmower dude, don't die in the water. Oh, was there a thing? Oh, how did I walk right past it? You feel like they added it because they saw Laura? That was my first thought. That's funny. Had to do that because he would have hit me and killed me.
Okay, if we can get a ship piece on this next stage, we'll actually be ahead. And that'd be good. No ship piece, but I'm gonna stay in the elevator. Never mind.
I forgot. You can only skip it in the air or in the water. The elevator doesn't matter. And this stage is huge. Use my wings. So then I should have done that at first. But there's no ship piece here, which is good because typically the elevator likes to be up here. Oh, it's not this time? Or am I too far? Not in the right spot. Check the islands. Go, 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 go. Oh, man. This is bad. This is really bad. Alright, I can't make that jump. Unless I do that. Hey, Freyon, what's up? Katarina was in the arcade version of Tekken 5 before they even knew Laura existed. Oh, okay. Well, then that's good. So it's not a copy-paste. There's more Icarus wings. That's good, too. There's my elevator, which is also good. Alright, so this wasn't a bad stage 10. That's actually really good. So, stage 11. And we've only got three pieces. That means they're going to start being stacked up pretty good, so I'll start having some green splits, but they're going to be on harder stages, which is the problem. And it's not on stage 11. I hope it's not on stage 13, because that's the... Well, 13's okay. That's the chicken stage. This stage was amazing. Oh, gosh. If the game could give me every other stage like this, I can finish in 25 minutes. Then I can have an unbeatable record. Who's Josie? If the only Josie I know is like from Josie and the Pussycats. There's a ship piece here. Okay, where are we at? Let's go this way. Did I pass it? Nope. Okay. Let's go here. Whoops. Oh, then who's Katarina? She's Filipino and her name's Josie. Okay, that's interesting. Katarina's the Brazilian chick. Okay. She does savate. Oh, okay. That's all good. Freon's like the god of knowledge when it comes to fighting games. So. All our facts can be checked easily. I'm gonna throw this decoy down. I hate spring shoes. There's only like four or five times when they're useful ever. Otherwise, they just make you move slower. Up. Yeah, the elevator's not down there. I don't know where the telephone is. I need to get over there. There's no way I try to jump for that though. No. Presence? Oh, he doesn't touch you while you're sleeping? Okay, I was gonna say, he definitely can. And he just took like two high tops and my wings. Freaking. All because of this stupid ship piece. Could have given me that ship piece on anywhere else. Any other stage. Because now I've lost everything. I should have flown. I was hoping for a boombox. That way she wouldn't trap me. Oh gosh. Oh, I only have a fudge sundae left. It doesn't even matter. Just take everything I own. Alright, so now the run has gone really bad. It went from nice time to like, hey, I got Maker's Wings back. Oh, from really good to like, oh no, this is not good at all. I might have to use them just to fly over there. What is down there? Let me go. Nothing. Oh no. Oh, this is bad. This stage sucks so much. There's always one of these maps in every run where you just like search in every logical spot. And the game's like, nah, we don't follow logic, man. We don't need any of that. Okay. But we can recover this, is the thing. Like, this is recoverable. It's bad, but it's not necessarily the end. I do have a lot of money. All I need is like a good mailbox with a Icarus Wings present inside.
I could buy like three of those.
So, we're still good. I just need to find this elevator. And I might have to fly to find it. Or I could just run. Okay, so the orange present is super high tops. So if I can just find super high tops and Icarus Wings, like, we'll be fine. Okay, now I gotta draw him off. Start. Look up. Look up. Dude. Look up. Get in the thing. Oh my gosh, I hate the moles. Good thing he only took my Fudge Sunday though, so we got lucky that time. They can take 1 to 3 presents, so he should have taken everything I owned.
So I really need to find a mailbox.
But I'll be actually ahead of pace now. This isn't a bad stage for a ship piece, because it's just chickens. Which, chickens control you and kill you. They're dangerous, but they're not as bad as boogeymen. Oh crap, there's moles here though. And that's really bad. So you have to like psych them out. Like, moles can be dodgeable. They're just a pain when they're right next to the elevator. Or wherever you were wanting to go. Okay, so there's the elevator, there's my ship piece. Perfect. Good. Now we're actually back. Glod. Wow. Now imagine how much better that would have been if the previous stage wouldn't have been so messed up and huge. And if I wouldn't have gotten my presents jacked. But that's good. I have a lot of money. I have 14 bucks. I need a carrot man so I can find a randomizer. I haven't seen a carrot man since stage... What was that? 5? Or was it 9? I don't know. So Jammin' Earl 3? You mean the one on Xbox? With Letitia or whatever her name is? It was weird. My sister rented it from Blockbuster because she's as big a Toe Jam and Earl fan as I am. I'm actually surprised. Like, she let me leave Texas with the Toe Jam and Earl game. Even though it's my system, but still. Ugh. Santa, I needed you. Didn't know the game existed all the way up to Xbox? Yeah. But she rented that game and she, like, played it for 10 minutes and then turned it off and was ready to take it back to Blockbuster. It sucked. Like, I wasn't a fan of Panic on Funkatron, but I would play Panic on Funkatron any day of the week compared to that game. The game is just utter trash. She likes his B2 and the wall ender Bruce does. That did silly damage when delayed. Oh, okay. Huh. So she's a solid character then. More wings, that's good too. I forget stage 14 is so big. I do need to find a carrot man really soon though. Our present stockpile's building back up, which is good. Oh no. Don't touch me. This is no bueno. Like, I have some good like some good stages and bad stages, then two bad splits and then a good split. Ah, no ship piece, right? There is a ship piece, dang it. Is it? There it is. Get out of here. Get out of the thing. And then he's not even going for the decoy. They already nerfed Akuma. That's kind of lame. We're still ahead though, so that's good. We only lost like 6 seconds. So we got 11 stages to go and we've got 4 ship pieces. I'm probably not gonna see another ship piece for like 5 stages. What kind of nerf did he get? Yeah, how's the fighting game scene going? I mean, I know Infiltration won Evo, which, like, no one in their right mind would have thought otherwise, honestly, I feel like. Like, when I saw his first 2 or 3 tournament wins, it was clearly apparent that he was going to win Evo. But, like, who else is shining up now? And what's the next major? Don't know what that is. Oh, that's Icarus Wings. I definitely want those. Fudo's good. Yeah, Fudo's good with our Mika. He had Infiltration beat if he wouldn't have messed up a combo. Yeah, I like Fudo with our Mika. I never thought that that would be his character, though. I always thought he would play with, like, anyone else. So it's cool to see him play with somebody like that. Don't want school book. See, that's one of the 5 decent uses of the spring shoes. There's a major going on right now. Yeah, I have to check it out tomorrow. During the Virtua Fighter days, he played Shun. Oh, did he? I didn't know that. Yeah, I remember that character. Don't take my wings. What are you? What is that pouch? Maybe that's a doorway or something. It's something good if he took it. There's presence everywhere. Wow. Instant demolish. Elevator would be good. Okay, that works too. Friend, what's a big Virtua Fighter guy? He used to win all of the nationals. Nice. He was sent abroad to fight, but there's no way he had a chance against Chibita and Fudo. This was no... Yeah, okay, let's go. I want to see them bring back, like, Battle Arena Tashenden. I want to see a sequel to that. Chibita is a guy who has been known to say the main point is not to win, but to make your opponent look like a complete clown. That's an interesting stance. Oh, this is Boogeyman stage. I definitely want to fly through this stage. Because, forget Boogeyman. Because I don't have that many unfalls. And I just want to get out quickly and painlessly. I played Virtua Fighter like 3 times. Ever. Not for dislike of it, just for like no one had it. We all played Tekken and Bloody Roar and Battle Arena Tashenden. Dang it. This is why I didn't want to. Wow, what is this stage? They just registered the trademark. Wait, who registered what trademark? What? For Battle Arena Tashenden? Steam ports? Ugh. Why would I want that stupid loop? Fine. Just leave me alone. Let me go up there. Oh gosh, why? Oh, they renewed the trademark for Virtua Fighter. Interesting. Oh, I want to see another Bloody Roar. Or another Rival Schools. Why don't you open? Thank you. Like, I didn't want to have to go all the way around. I didn't want to have to use my Icarus wings for that. That would have been terrible. All right, so now we're behind again. I do want this decoy because they've actually been serving me pretty well. Look at all these gifts. Why are there boogeymen everywhere? A new Bloody Roar with graphics today. Oh, that'd be so amazing. That would be really cool. Like Tekken 5 or Tekken 7 or Street Fighter 5 graphics on Bloody Roar. That'd be pretty sweet. All right, no ship piece here either. Remember what I told you? We're not gonna see a ship piece for like four stages. I wasn't lying to you. I need another Carrot Man though, like terribly badly. I have all of these unopened presents, but I worry about popping a randomizer and losing my Icarus wings and my high tops from being identified. However, I will need to pop something soon because our time's starting to fall behind. We're just now hitting 2 minutes a stage, so we're being pressed for time now. I won't beat the world record at this run, but I could still PB. And if I'm lucky enough, I could PB by 5 minutes, which would be pretty amazing. You know, I'm gonna pop that boombox, cause he annoys me. Oh, where's my elevator? Please, game. Don't troll me. Dude, this root beer burps are lasting forever. It's pretty amazing. No. Oh, okay. Where is it? Oh man, oh, it's way down there, I see it. I know I have food in here somewhere. Yes. The new King of Fighters is pretty cool. I wouldn't mind playing it. I'm not sure how I outran him. You typically can't. Oh no. Okay, I got lucky there. It's like 13 with its super high damage, but without the combos, 50 minutes every time you get hit.
Are there any cool new characters on it? I don't know anything about the new King of Fighters.
Yeah, there we go, our ship piece, four stages later-ish. Wow, I dodged every tomato and the tornado. That was pretty baller. Good to see my dodging skills haven't deteriorated. Team Mexico. Here's our ship piece. We're only 7 minutes behind now. No big deal. There's our elevator. No, you weren't supposed to grab me. New super anime dude. Nice. Don't drop me, no. Thank you. Oh, my presents, get off me. I don't need more money, game. I don't. You're so mean. Psych. Look at all this cash. I can't do anything with all these dollars you give him a game. Jeez. Oh wait, didn't I just grab the ship piece? I'm an idiot. I already picked up the ship piece. Oh my gosh. The tornado brought me to the elevator and I'm like, oh, I still gotta go get the piece. Oy, oy, oy. Well, that was a waste of time. Dang it. Ship piece here, so that means the last three stages will be where two of them are. Last three stages for two of them, and one in like the next stage. But I'll have completed a run for the first time in a while, so I guess that's decent. Assuming I live, right? Should just be following the road for the elevator. I don't have food. Should've just followed the road. Don't be a mailbox monster. Ah, yes, let me buy an extra buck with all this money. Let me buy more money. Game. I didn't see that it was already open there. I didn't see that it was there. I could have left the stage a long time ago. That's mistake number two with that. And this, less than 3 minutes, I've made the same mistake twice. This is why looking at your map does have its uses. That was, man, that's lame. I'm back to streaming. It's just, I don't have a schedule because work is weird. So no Sundays is like my only schedule. Other than that, it depends on my work schedule. Because it changes all the time. Well, hey, look, it was in this stage, just like I said. Good thing I have an unfall. More Nokia streams? No thanks. I'll pass on that. I probably won't ever go and finish like everything in Digimon. And if I do, it'd be in like normal mode. or something. I'm done playing that game. And I'm pretty sure Sky's not gonna play that game after seeing me play it. Like, just the story plot. There's a lot of good things about that game, but just those characters, man. And those challenges are stupid. They are ridiculously hard. Which, I mean, it's doable because Rem did it. So I know it's doable. I just don't have the time to invest into that. If I did, I would do it, but I don't have that kind of time. So there's the elevator now for the shit piece. Wait, where's the rest of the... Okay, so where's the rest of the stage? I didn't get any more high tops, which is also really bad. And I don't have another pair of Icarus wings, which is... terrible. I had like 4 more seconds of flight. More money. And more money. I've never seen so much money. I've got 32 bucks, and I've passed up on money that I was on the ground. It's not even here. Where's the rocket ship piece? I don't have a doorway. There's my doorway. Wow. That's probably Rip, actually. That's actually probably Rip. Yeah, that's Rip. Because that snakes its way, way over there. So, Rip time. I'll finish the run. But that's Rip. That sucks. It was promising. At ship piece 3 and ship piece 5 and 6. It was like, it could have been something great. And then the maps just went back to being trolls. Super trolls. Oh, hi, Boogeyman. Oh, that's why I didn't pick it up, because it was a school book. Ow. Oh, the land generation. Wait, what? See, this layout's not even my fault. You can't do anything about that. Can't do anything about that. Now, I lost 2 high tops and Icarus wings. That wouldn't have really made a difference. And I passed up the elevator twice. And so that cost me about a minute. That still wouldn't have made a difference. Because these layouts just kind of bad. I still have to go all the way around to get over here. And these mailboxes haven't had anything good in them. So, it was just a dead run that seemed promising enough to make you keep running it once you're halfway through. That happens sometimes, though.
So I've been trying to figure out how I could stream my Japanese streams on the creative channel under the creative label thing. I just don't know how. So
I probably won't. And so on days I don't stream, I'm either working or I'm studying Japanese so I can regain my fluency. So I'm quite serious about that. So like maybe 3 days out of the week, I probably won't stream so I can dedicate it to studying. Yeah, I know people do it, but I just don't know how they, like, I still haven't figured out how Twitch, like, moderates that stuff and what is okay and what's not. I know some people, like, work on their cars or whatever. Like, people do some crazy things in the creative channel that doesn't necessarily seem creative, because that feels, it's still, it's on Twitch, so it has to be video game related, right? So like if I was parsing, translating games, okay, I could see that, but I'm not doing that. I'm just straight up studying like actual material, as if I were going to take the JLPT, which I would at one day, so I can get that certificate. So I don't see it. Yeah, exactly. Homework, all that stuff. And it's just like, I don't know. You're just allowed to do that. Yeah, I know there's the social eating thing now, and that's only because it was big in Korea. So I'm just like, this is so weird. I don't understand what Twitch is wanting to do anymore. We're definitely just like going back to the JTV days. It's kind of weird. So we're gonna die here a few times. Or just once. Feeding Japanese to your brains. I mean, yeah. I mean, I guess I could do social eating and just like eat while I'm studying, but that just seems weird. I don't know. You gotta do an N2 and leave your testing there. Yeah, I wanna get the highest one. I wanna do all of it. There's that one and then the, what is it? The Celta or Celta or something like that. There's two tests you can take. Yeah, I wanna do both of them. And complete them both at their highest level. And then I want to learn Korean, and then I guess Chinese would be next, like Mandarin. And then probably move into like European languages / Spanish Romance languages. I might learn Indian after that. Like, I want to learn languages that are most practical to my area after Japanese. So that would mean Indian or Chinese. But I kind of want to do Korean first because of how similar it is to Japanese. So I guess the ideal path would probably be to do Indian and then Mandarin and then Korean if I were to do the optimal path. Or I guess Indian, Mandarin, then Spanish, then Korean, or maybe Russia's even before Korean, because there are quite a few people from Russia out here. Learn Sanskrit. Study Japanese sign language. Oh, that would be awesome. I do want to learn sign language as well. Japanese sign language would be really cool. Of course, the last shit piece is on last stage 25. So let's just try to burn through this stage. Can I finish in under an hour? I want to learn like all the languages if I could. If I had the time, I would want to learn every language in the universe. I died. Hey, Oreo Dunk. I am back, but my throat is killing me because it's the first stream back. So after this run, which is in like 5 or 10 minutes, I'll be done for the night. Hey, Bowser Mouth. That nerd van. Yeah, the ice cream truck sucks. The ice cream truck is really bad. The lawnmowers suck. The dentists suck because all three of them outspeed you. The boogeyman and the mole man are the most annoying. All like 6,000 languages on Earth? Yeah. Yep, yep. I would love to learn all 6,000 if I could. Yeah. Hey, DJ Flashpoint, what's good, man? Thank you for the host. How have you been, homie? Once you get into two, you'll do Spanish or Portuguese. Nice. Yeah, I'm a backer for that game. I've been a backer for the new Toe Jam and Earl for over a year, or since pretty much when the Kickstarter came out. I got this hoodie that I'm wearing.
You can't really see very well. It's actually for
the new Toe Jam and Earl game, and I got a mug and like a Carrot Man keychain and two posters. I think I'll get an extra copy or two of the game. If I get extra copies, I'll do a giveaway for them, for sure. So yeah, that's definitely gonna happen. Okay. Didn't mean to use the wings, but whatever. Hey, Hoverboy, what's up? It's been a while. I apologize. Things have been a little bit nuts. What kind of last stage is this? Come on, I'm trying to finish in under an hour. Leave me alone. Wow. Why? Where is it? There it is. That's a terrible run.
That's a really bad run. One glod, one green.
Ugh. But I guess when you don't play for a few months, that's kind of what happens. I'm glad to be back. It's very tiring on my throat, though, for sure. Speech therapy has a long way to go, which that's what they said. You know, they said it'd be like 6 months to a year. So, but we got a run done. Yay. I was worried the game was going to troll us the entire night. Now, if I was Earl, that time would be good. Because Earl's really slow. But with ToeJam, that's not the greatest time. But it's under an hour. It's okay. You can stream more if you drop out of employment. That is not true. Because remember, that is why I stopped streaming before. Because the medical issue kept me from streaming. And I couldn't pay my bills. And my internet was shut off. That's why I was gone for 2 months. So technically not true. People aren't as interested in streams of my type anymore. I don't play the kind of games people like to see, so. And my time slot's really bad, so. As a streamer, I don't think I'm competitive anymore. You will pay my internet. But then if I lose my apartment, then it doesn't matter if my internet's paid. It worked out for you. That's nice. My kind of games are just mostly like RPGs. So this kind of a time slot, playing like JRPGs at that, and not being able to play a lot of games that tend to be popular. I don't know. It just never worked out. There was one time it did, and I broke over 200 viewers a night. And Twitch still said that wasn't good enough for sub button. And then I got busy with school, so, you know. After 4 years of just kind of gauging what I stream, how I stream, and just kind of trends. How many viewers do you pull while so clutch? But yeah, after 4 years of doing this, you know. If I wasn't in grad school, that's the other thing. Like, if I was never doing college stuff and wasn't having to take hiatuses like the 3 or 4 times I did because school just got so busy and whatnot, then who knows? I guess I'm not sure what you mean by worked out for you. I mean work out in the sense of being able to be competitive with Twitch enough to get a sub button and have that be a living. I can't do that during this time slot. So. Yeah. I mean, I always streamed for fun, but I also took a real shot at trying to make it full time. Oh, you mean you like the game? Got you. Okay, I thought you meant for the stream. That's what I was like, how'd you do it? So, I mean, Twitch is more competitive in the sense that there's more people on it, but they're also playing. They're all playing games that I don't play, so I'm not necessarily competing with them. Well, I am in the sense of the fact that the games that I play aren't games that people typically like to watch. So I'm competing with people who play games that other people want to watch, which is the first problem. And that's because of motion sickness. So. But yeah, just following trends over 4 years of doing this. It just, a full-time streaming thing is not in the cards for me, which is fine. Like, that was never my intent when I started streaming. It was just to stream and have fun. And it took a real push to try to get a sub button because it'd be nice to have. So I can have emotes for everyone. But it was never to, you know, the push was to see, like, if I could do it and if I could become a full-time streamer and what I would do if I did. But it was never I am dropping my entire world to become a full-time streamer because I was still working then. But I still streamed like 40 hours a week at that time. So, but it's all good. I don't mind. I just stream for fun, and anyone who comes and chills, we chill and have a good time. COD Blops. What's COD Blops? I know that that's Call of Duty something something something, right? You love the Digital Devil Saga run? Yeah, see, I like those kinds of games. Viewers are not as loyal anymore. The viewer base is looking for something more of a reactive streamer. Yeah, I think I can. Yeah, Black Ops, yeah. There's no way I'd be vomiting everywhere. Still hope to meet me at a con. Well, I won't be at PAX this year. Next year. I don't know. But yeah, PAX Prime, I won't be at this year unless somebody just randomly has a ticket that they don't need. I won't be at PAX. I will try to go to the like after party thing to meet people, but I doubt it. This year's probably just not gonna happen. But I would still like to go to cons, yes. Planning to do some vlog teaching kinds of videos for YouTube since you have great upload speed for Twitching. Oh, that's cool. Yeah, it just didn't work out for me financially because this year's been weird up to this point with my finances. So with me just now starting work, I'm still trying to get my finances fixed and I gotta pay off this credit card that I had to take off just to keep my apartment when I started this job. And everything, like, I don't have the cash to go on Reddit and buy a ticket for a day. So, unless somebody has a ticket for free, I won't be at PAX Prime this year. But I would like to make it out to other cons, so we'll see what happens. If anyone goes to the Geek Girl Con, I'll actually be there. But that's because I'll be there for work. So... I'll be at the Geek Girl Con, and I'll be at the Geek Wire conference, but that's for work. So, if you're there, I can say hi to you there. But other than that, nothing planned for this year. We'll see how next year goes. For sure. Jeggerd the Geek Girl. I mean, I do make a pretty geek girl, right? But I think for today, I'm gonna stop here because it's the first stream in 2 months. I don't wanna overdo my throat. I wanna see how it feels tomorrow. Tomorrow's no stream, Sundays are never streams. I still have a lot of stuff. Like, I'm just now done with grad school, but I have to like now shift out of grad school mode and take care of all the things that I couldn't take care of outside of grad school. And Sundays are definitely gonna be designated study Japanese days. Outside of that, I should be back like Monday or Tuesday, and again, the rest of the schedule's up in the air, so you just have to hit follow here or follow me on Twitter. I will keep you updated for sure on if I'm gonna go live that night or not. It was nice meeting you too, Wow So Clutch. I'm glad to see you too, Hoverboard and Psyka. Glad to be back. When I'm back on Monday or Tuesday, I will be starting Bloodborne. So, bring your theories, bring your ideas, bring your discussions. We will talk about all that stuff and it will be cool. But for now, that is it for me. I hope y'all have a good night. I'm gonna host somebody because I haven't got to host someone in like months. It's kind of cool. So let's see. Yeah. Who am I gonna host? My follows list. I have a following list. I haven't looked at this thing in forever. Who streams still? Does anyone still stream? Oh, Baki's live. I'm gonna host Baki. Mr. Baki Hama. I haven't seen him in forever. You'll be here in the future? Y'all better be here. Streaming Buddha. Why am I Buddha? I don't know. I'm confused. Yeah, I'm gonna host Baki Hanma 20. So that's gonna be it for me. I will see y'all later. Thank you for coming around. And peace out.